Daily news, everyday news, breaking news on Prince Miller Entertainment TV. Subscribe to the channel, follow us on all our social media platforms on Instagram, Prince Miller Entertainment, Facebook, our Prince Miller Entertainment, Facebook group, our Prince Miller Entertainment TV. We're also available on Twitter at PMillerENT. You need to follow us on Twitter and we follow back. Today is the 15th of November 2021. It's sad news, man, and it's shocking. So, a 34-year-old Zimbabwean national who has been living in South Africa illegally has been arrested for murder, rape, defeating the ends of justice and robbery in the neighboring country. The South African Police Service, SAPS, said the man is linked to the disappearance and killing of seven women between August and October this year. The bodies were discovered in different locations in the bush in Shishego, Polokwane, Makweng, and Westernburg. All the deceased have been positively identified by their next of kin. The suspect allegedly lured his victims by promising them jobs through social media. SAPS spokesperson Brigadier Mohlafela Mojapelo said the suspect had earlier been arrested for the alleged possession of a suspected stolen cell phone, but further investigations revealed the murders. He said, "We have arrested a 34-year-old suspect whom we believe to be responsible for a series of murders whose victims were all women. We can confirm that seven bodies have already been recovered from different locations under Shishego, Polokwane, and Western policing areas. The suspect is being charged with murder, rape, defeating the ends of justice, and robbery. One of the men's victims was identified as Sarah Motiba, 42, who was last seen leaving home for work in Polokwane on the 18th of last month. The suspect reportedly demanded 2,500 ransom from the Motiba family at Gachuene, promising to release Sarah. Family spokesperson Violeta Rakoma Motiba said, "We are unable to accept what happened. He tricked us and made us pay ransom money, promising to release Sarah. He stole cash that Sarah had, withdrew her money at the bank, and made the family pay ransom money and ended up killing her. We are hurt. Justice must prevail. He must disclose the names of the people he was working with. I don't believe he was alone in this crime. I hope the police can also help to make him disclose the names." The suspect, who is also facing multiple charges, is expected to appear before the Shishego Magistrate Courts on Monday. Yes, I've seen it on news. Right now, people are demonstrating at Shishego Magistrate Court. And this is one of those cases that I've been talking about here so many times. I know that some Zimbos, they don't want to hear this, but this is true. We are contributing to crime in South Africa, in Dutch Wallis Chongo Report. That is the reason why most of them, they really don't want us here. They want us to go back to Zimbabwe because of this. And this is said, at the same time, I will send condolences messages to all the families who have lost their loved ones. I mean, it's no good words. So, you know, I demand a mari, opo a mari, what drew a mari in my account. At the same time, this is sad, and this is evil. This is bad, and let's hope that the police have more evidence against this person. At the same time, if he was working with other people, he needs to disclose those names of those people, because we really don't want those people in our communities. And again, as you know, she being started in Zimbabwe and South Africa, there are people who are honestly working very hard to feed their families back home. Then there are few people who are rotten apples and who are causing problems for us. And it's not a good look. It's not a good look at all for us here in South Africa. So, get it in the comment section. I'll come back here, get any new information, and here on daily news, everyday news, on breaking news. I just saw it on TV, on News Africa, and people were protesting outside Shishego Magistrate Court today, saying that police are being too soft on these foreigners. And so, bye. Daily News, Everyday News, Breaking News on Prince Miller Entertainment TV. And again, get it out in the comment section. Remember, guys, to like, share, and comment, and follow us on all our social media platforms, Instagram, Facebook, and also on our Facebook group. This is Daily News, Everyday News, Breaking News on Prince Miller Entertainment TV. Listen.